Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, today we are going to study different types of refractories and which refractory should we use if certain kinds of reactions are happening in our crucible or in our blast furnace. So by lining our blast furnace or crucibles with any refractory, first we need to verify whether that refractory will be chemically active or inactive with all the reactions which are happening in our blast furnace, which include combustion reactions, many different types of gaseous reactions, and the refractory should be unaffected by it. The two most important things to keep in account while choosing a refractory, the first is it should withstand high temperatures, extremely high temperatures, and second is it should also withstand extremely high pressures. But apart from that, what is more important is the refractory should not react with anything that is happening inside the blast furnace. So how do we find such materials which do not react with anything which is happening inside the blast furnace? Because almost all elements react with one another, especially at given environments at high temperatures, high pressures, where the coke is continuously lead in, the fuel is continuously given in, almost every element tends to react a little with it. So how do we decide upon the refractories which we should be using to line up the blast furnace? Well, for that we should know the classification of refractories. Refractories are classified into two: acidic refractories and basic refractories. Acidic refractories may also be called as acid-friendly refractories, and basic refractories may also be called as base-friendly refractories. Now, what do I mean by the acid-friendly refractories? If I know that I have to do a metallurgy on iron wherein a lot of acid will be formed, a lot of acidic gases will be formed, then I have to use acidic refractories, because acidic refractories are the refractories which are unaffected by acids. They will not react with acids at all. They are okay with acids being them inside the blast furnace at extremely high temperatures and not reacting to it at all. The two most important components of acidic refractories are alumina and silica. The refractories which contain both of these things are acid refractories, and then we have to go and search for such refractories and classify them accordingly for our own purpose. The most common examples of acid refractories are fire clay and quartz. Both of them can be lined to any blast furnaces which will have reactions producing a lot of acids, and then they will not react to it, making sure that the acid reactions are held completely and the metals are then extracted in the most pure form. Basic refractories. Basic refractories are the refractories which will not get affected with any reactions involving basicity of metals. So now if I have bases coming out of the reaction, after the reaction is done, those bases will not affect the interior lining of the blast furnace, which is lined up with the base refractories, also known as the basic refractories. But basic refractories can easily get reactive with anything acidic that is happening inside the blast furnace. So now if I know that I have reactions and combustions which are going to form acids in it, I should not be lining the refractories with a basic lining. The constituents of basic refractories are basic oxides. For example, we have calcium oxide or magnesium oxide. Both of these are the main basic oxides formed in the basic refractories. The two most important examples of basic refractories are bauxites and chromites. In this video, we studied the classification of different refractories, the acidic and the basic refractories. Thank you so much for watching this video. Stay tuned to Ikeda and subscribe to Ikeda.